हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई स्टार्ट क्लास 12 चैप्टर 3 पार्ट 2। चैप्टर नेम इज़ पॉलिनेशन, फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एंडोस्पर्म एंड एम्ब्रायो। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी वेर डिस्कस अबाउट पॉलिनेशन, देयर टाइप्स, देयर एजेंट। ओके, इन दिस वीडियो वी वेर डिस्कस अबाउट इनकॉम्पैटिबिलिटी। इनकॉम्पैटिबिलिटी डेफिनेशन: the unsuccess of fertilization between the totally functional and fertile male and female gamete is called incompatibility or unfertility. Okay, so incompatibility means, first of all, fertilization means, you know that fusion of male gamete and female gamete to form zygote. Here when incompatibility means the male gamete and female gamete is totally functional, but they are not, they cannot fuse together to make a zygote. So when they are functionally but it is not compatible to each other, so that is known as incompatibility. The gametes are functionally, means it is okay, there is no problem in that gamete, not even in male gamete, not even female gamete, but they are not compatible to each other to fuse and form a zygote. That is known as incompatibility. Now, types of incompatibility. Incompatibility are divided into two types: interspecific and intraspecific. Interspecific we will discuss briefly in later. First we will know the types. Now again, intraspecific is divided into two types, that is gametophytic incompatibility and sporophytic incompatibility. Okay, now first one is intraspecific incompatibility. When the incompatibility between different members of species, different member of species of a genera is called interspecific compatibility. All you know that what is genus and what is species. In one genus, there are so many species are present. Like that, you have seen the scientific name here, Brassia campestris. Here it is a genus and it is a species. Okay, in Brassia another species is Strepa. So when the incompatibility happen between the different species but the genus are same, when the incompatibility occur between the different species, different member of species but the genus are same, we call it interspecific incompatibility. Got it the point? When the incompatibility between different member of species of a genus is called interspecific incompatibility, means they cannot compatible with the different species. Means genus is same, we call it interspecific. Example is Brassia campestris and Brassia repa. These are the two same genus but the species are different, they are not compatible to each other. Now the next one is intraspecific, which prevent the self-fertilization between same species and thus there encourage outcrossing. Means there's in same species they are not compatible to each other, they is compatible to for the outcrossing. Means that gamete is compatible for the other plant, they will encourage the outcrossing, but their self-fertilization is not occur. That is known as incompatibility. It is again divided into two types, that is gametophytic incompatibility and sporophytic incompatibility. So first are gametophytic incompatibility. Outcome of interaction between the pollen tube and style is determined the genotype of pollen grain. This is the important line. Means gametophytic, means gametophytic word is coming from the gamete. Gamete is for pollen. So when the incompatibility we can know by the genotype of pollen. Genotype means gene characters of the pollen. We will decide that compatibility or not. It is compatibility or not. So when outcome of interaction between the pollen tube and the style is determined by the genotype of pollen. Pollen is what? Gamete. That is known as gametophytic incompatibility. Gametophytic word is for the gamete. So when it is governed by the genotype of pollen. Here you can see the diagram and then you will understand. This is anther. In anther, the alleles means alternative forms of gene, alternating forms of genes. They have a S1 and S2 allele. There is carpal and here is another carpal. Their allele is S3, S4, here S1 and S3. So when the pollen grain is present in anther, so that is when pollen grain is coming S1 and S2. Here, if it is not matched with any of the allele of pistil, then we call it, then the pollen tube is coming out, that is known as pollen tube is coming out when it is not matched. Here allele is S1, S2 and here is S3 and is S4. They both are different. They both have different. They are not matching to each other. Then the pollen tube is coming out. Got it? The point here in second one, there is, it can be fertilized. It can be fertilized. But when here is again pollen grain is S1 and S2 and here is S1 and S3. Here what is that? S2 and so S1 and S1 is matched to each other, but so there is pollen tube is not coming out, and here S2 and S3 it is not matching to each other, then the pollen tube is coming out. We can call it is partially compatible. It is not fully compatible, it is fully compatible. Okay, when the, so simply you have to know that when the alleles are matched with each other, then the fertility not occur, fertilization not occur, and when it is not matched to each other, then the fertilization occur. In second point, both are different. S1 allele is here S3 is there, S2 is there, S4 is there. Both are different, so the pollen tube is coming out, that means fertilization occurred, that means it is fully compatible, and here it is not same. Here S1 and S1 is same, so here pollen tube is not coming out, and here S2 and S3, they both are different. So it is partially compatible to each other. Now the next one is sporophytic incompatibility. Outcome of interaction between the pollen tube and stylus determine the genotype of sporophyte. That means sporophyte means from where the pollen tube is produced, we can determine by the sporophyte. That means that plant by which the pollen tube is produced. So it is, again you can see the diagram here, that is anther, anther here allele is S1 S2, here you can see S1 S2, here S3, S4 pistil and pistil. So S1 and S3, that means both are not matching with each other. We can, that means pollen tube is coming, and S2 and S4 again it is not matched. So here fertilization occur. It is compatible. It is fully compatible. But here S1 and S2, it is coming out from the plant that is have a S1 and S2 allele. So S1 and S3, here S2 is what, dominant, so it is not produced any pollen tube. Got it from here. So here is not, it is also incompatible to each other. Okay.